Africa's very much in fashion right now in the art world. Everyone in the world is looking at us, and what was imperative for us was not to really focus on the fashion, but to focus on the legacy of this moment and say, before this focus moves somewhere else, let's build a major institution so we can continue to position our artists from Africa on the global stage in an equal, fair way.
I'm just happy for African artists to be able to showcase artwork and have a platform like this on an international level.
There's a very strong dialogue between the architecture of the building and the architecture of the shows, or what our mission is, but also the architecture of what it represents.
I was just blown away by the building itself. It's an amazing design, so I recommend everyone come and see it.
You know, art is a kind of labor, but it's a labor for the soul and the mind, whereas this building was a labor for the stomach, for nourishment. As a cutting-edge contemporary museum, what interests us the most is to be in this constant conversation with artists, this constant dialogue with them, and have the curator and the artists in this conversation creating something new, something fresh, something evocative, and sometimes something challenging and controversial as well. We understand that in the past in our country, most of our museums not only didn't allow access, whether it was legally or psychologically, because museums are very intimidating places, but also they didn't represent the totality of the people of our country or our continent. For too long, unfortunately, the narrative of Africa has been written by outsiders. And we wanted to create a platform to say to the curators, the theorists, the philosophers, the artists, and the public, let's all participate in writing a story and a narrative of how we want to tell our story to the world, and not only just accept how it's told for us.